Are y'all getting past the hair? Can we get past the hair in this video? Okay, good. Just checking. Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. As you can see from today's look, you know, it's just something you're gonna wear if you wanna go pick up milk from the grocery store, church, picking up dry cleaning, walking your dog, you know, just those things. This is what this is for. So this is my like welcoming in spring look. I am so excited that it's spring. I love having the windows open just to like hear the birds and feel the sun. I was inspired by this look from, who was it? The name is, oh Lord. I don't know how to pronounce it. This is a look I was inspired by. And a lot of times if I see a look, it's like, I know it's not going to turn out exactly how that is, which is what's pretty cool because you can be inspired by a look and just use what you got and recreate the look. I'm always going to give credit where credit is due. If I don't come up with the look myself, I'm going to tell you what inspired me for the look. In this video, I also used a palette that I have never used before, just to try it out and see. This company is more on the, I don't want to say cheap, like inexpensive side. BH Cosmetics is a more affordable cosmetic brand. But I've personally never seen or heard of the palette that I used in this video. So you'll see what happens if you watch this video. But I had a lot of fun doing this look, recreating this look, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So yeah, let's go ahead and get on to this spring colorful pretty video. So I'm just gonna take a little concealer and prime my eyes. And then set it with some powder. Okay, so this next eyeshadow palette, I just bought off of an impulse, man. Like I was trying to get away from like the Morphe palettes because I'm obsessed with Morphe palettes. And I probably would own all of them if it was up to me. So I don't know why this palette intrigued me so much. This is the BH Cosmetics Take Me to Brazil palette. Because I wanted a really colorful eyeshadow palette. And I know there are so many out there. And like the Smashbox ones were calling my name. And of course, like I said, the Morphe ones. But I wanted to try like a different brand, a different company, just to like, I don't know, just to try it out. And these palettes are so inexpensive. And from the reviews that I was reading about these palettes, like the color payoff is pretty good. So I was like, let's just try it out. Let's get away from Morphe. And let's just try something completely different and new. I'm hoping this is like a diamond in the rough and it works and the color payoff is good. So I don't know, let's just see. So I think I'm gonna start with this corner purple shade right here and just put that into my crease. Okay. Okay, there's not much pigment on here. I'm going to try this shade and see if I can get any pigment out of this one. Okay, that's better. That's giving me something here. Okay, this pigment is good. Much better. Next, I'm gonna take that first brush I used, just a big fluffy brush, and what was I gonna dip into? I'm going to dip into this darker purple and just blend those two together. I'm gonna take this shade right here and pack that on my brush and put that on the outer part of my eyelid. I'm gonna go back in and take some more of this and just define my crease a little bit more. Now I'm going to go in with Urban Decay's eyeshadow in the shade Midnight Cowboy and put that on the inner part of my eyelid. I'm just going to take some setting spray, any type of setting spray, and like a packer brush, and spritz my brush with it, and then pack that on, pack the eyeshadow on that way. I don't know how I feel about this palette. This might have to be given to my younger nieces just to play with. I'm actually going to go in with ColourPop's eyeshadow in the shade Fantasy and put some of this in the crease. Now I'm just going to go back in with that Midnight Cowboy. I think I get more color payoff using my finger. So I'm just going to use my finger for this. Now I'm going to take L'Oreal Infallible Paints eyeliner in the shade Electric Blue and do a wing. I need like two hands to do wing liner because that is always going to be my struggle in life, is a wing liner. So for those of you who can do a wing liner, I don't like you. Okay, so still going with the eyes here. I'm going to go in with another ColourPop eyeshadow, and this is in the shade Too Shy, and put that on my lower lash line. Now I'm going to use NYX white eyeliner and put this on my waterline. Now I'm going to dip into the Morphe 35F palette and pick up some of this gold shade right here and put that on my inner corners. Now I'm going to pop these lashes on by Eyelur. These are in the style, I think it's Barbecue, whatever it is. But as always, everything you want to know is always down below. The mascara I'm going to be using today is the Tarte Lights Camera Flashes. Can you see it with yellow background? Finally, we're to the face. For primer today, I'm going to go in with the combo that I have been loving lately, which is the Urban Decay Optical Illusion Complexion Primer and the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. The foundation I'm going to use is by Urban Decay. It's the All Nighter Foundation in the shade 0.5. I'm just taking a foundation brush and buffing this in, and then I will go in and further blend it with my Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. For concealer today, I'm going to go in with my Makeup Forever Ultra HD in the shade R20 and my Kat Von D Lock It Concealer in L1 Natural. You already know I'm setting with the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. And then setting the rest of my face with my trusty Kat Von D Powder Foundation in the shade Light. Now I'm going to bring back the color to my face because Lord knows I need it with my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil Bronzer in Medium. For blush, I'm gonna go in with my dirty ass Morphe 9B blush palette and dip into the shade. I'm gonna use this shade, why not? Let's go for it. The highlight I'm gonna be using today has been, like, believe it or not, like my go-to highlighter, even a little bit over the Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit, which is crazy, but for a drugstore highlight, yes, drugstore highlight, it is amazing. It's the Wet n Wild, yeah, Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder in the shade Precious Petals, and it is bomb. Don't sleep on it, it is bomb. You ready for it? Oh my god, so pretty! I freaking love it! Look at it. I just love it. For a drugstore highlight, I'm just obsessed with it. If you never knew, highlighting is my favorite part of, like, my makeup routine. So I always become super happy and obsessed when it's time to highlight. For lips, I'm gonna use a Gerard Cosmetics. This is their matte liquid lipstick in the shade Serenity. I'm going to pop some of that, my eyes are watering like crazy. I'm also going to pop some of that Wet n Wild highlight on my brow bone. Now I'm going to set my face with my I'm going to set my face with my Ofra Mixer Setting Spray. You don't want to move when you set your face. Don't move your face. So this is the final look, guys. I am in love with it. It screams spring, and it also screams a little bit of, like, the music festival vibes, you know, that everybody gets in every year, like the Coachella and just all the, like, Bunbury, like all those different music festivals where, like, the fashion and the makeup is, like, what's so much fun about them. So my take on the BH Cosmetics Take Me to Brazil palette, I swatched some more of the shadows. Some of them are really pigmented and really just, like, have great texture to them. They're creamy, they blend out really nice. And then there's other ones of them that's not so much. But for the price of it, I figured, eh, what the hell, you know, just go ahead and buy it, try it out. If it's good, it's good. If it's not, you know, maybe just stick to what I know. But venturing out and trying new things with makeup, that's what it's about, right? So I'm still glad I bought it, even though it might not be as much of, like, a go-to palette as I was hoping for. You already know what I'm gonna say. If you've been watching since day one, if you liked this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. And like always, I will see you on my next one. Thanks for watching. Bye. Spring has sprung. Now I'm gonna set my face. In my last what? Hey, brush. I kinda need you, bruh. If you think I'm serious and watch my videos and think I'm serious, then you shouldn't watch my videos.